I am Aaron Cruz, and I am running for the United States Senate against Dianne Feinstein. Yes, as Trump calls her, Sneaky Feinstein. So let me tell you a little bit about myself. I'm a mother of two grown children, widow of internationally renowned scientist Rene Cruz. I am a political activist, and I am a published author of the political and communication book Revolution America, Communication Toolbox for the Modern Conservative American Woman. Last week, the California Democrat Party made national headlines by not endorsing Senator Dianne Feinstein. Yes, career politician Dianne Feinstein. Now, many in the mainstream media, including The Hill, reported, and this made major headlines, Feinstein fails to win endorsement from the California Democrats. That may be the first logical decision that the left has made in years. Yes. They also did not endorse Kevin DeLeon, her Democrat front runner. Yes. That was great news. Now, this is also not surprising of the Democrat Party of No, right? The badly broken Democrat Party of No can't find anyone or anything they're actually for besides illegal aliens first, besides colossal fails on issues that matter to Americans, and besides perpetual grandstanding, something we've seen over and over and over again, instead of actual governance, which we need so desperately. I am calling on the California Republican Assembly to make big and bold headlines this week as the party of yes, as the party of united and unlimited possibility. I am calling on you, the California Republican Assembly, for a resounding yes. We can win back Congress in 2018. Yes, we, the California Republican Assembly, endorse Aaron Cruz as the next U.S. Senator of the great and golden state of California. The principles the CRA was founded on 83 years ago are still as solid and essential today as they were back in July of 1935. Constitutional and first principles, not politicians, not political correctness, are the bedrock of our core beliefs as Republicans. We believe in our Judeo-Christian foundation and the Creator, from whom all blessings and all rights of life, liberty, and justice flow. While we may not have seen much recently of God and the Golden State, as shamefully one of our own NFL teams led the nation in kneeling against our anthem, that has less to do with free speech and the First Amendment, which we as Republicans so hold so absolute, and had more to do with the left's anti-American agenda and its feigned protest for principles. It is in the enduring values of In God We Trust and God Bless America and our faith in the best of what America is that stands as the evidence of things not yet seen and the confidence for that which we hope for, a free and prosperous California. We believe, and I say we because I stand with you, we believe California can once again lead and inspire the nation and make right the problems that are in our backyard. DACA and Dreamers are our political footballs Dems toss around at every election cycle. Kate's Law, Build the Wall, Work for All are winning solutions. Those are winning solutions, folks. And I know you agree with me here at the CRA.
Yes.
Yes. But as President Trump has exposed our current Congress, and especially the Democrat crime syndicate, Dianne Feinstein, Mad Maxine Waters, Loony Ted Lieu, Jerry Brown, just to name a few. Just a few, there are many, many more, work against the best interests of the very people they are supposed to represent, which are you and me. We believe California can once again shine as the golden standard of states, where individualism, less government, not more taxation, less innovation in technology, in infrastructure, agriculture, arts and entertainment, our environment even, and rejuvenated excellence in education define who we are. We believe the sun has not yet set on our golden state, and our future is bright.
Yes.
It's the natural beauty we are so blessed with here in California. But California has been broken under unchecked political corruption. We are near death as a soulless state. And I've heard that resounding in all of the speakers running and candidates running here today. I am running to be your next U.S. Senator to crush corruption that Dianne Feinstein and the California Democrats epitomize. I am running to be your next U.S. Senator because now we have an incredible opportunity after the Make America Great Again movement of 2016 to ride that red wave of renewed American exceptionalism and patriotism in 2018 that resurrects the spirit of zestful optimism in our own Ronald Reagan. I'm almost done. We as Californians have an incredible intrinsic opportunity and ability to passionately pursue dreams and live life large, but we have lost our vision, our inspiration, our moral center. If left in the hands of Democrats, the party of no, the party of anti-America, because that's what they are, we may never find our way back to greatness, except for us in this room filled with Californians, except for us, California Republican Assembly, grassroots patriots across the state who continue to work relentlessly to restore American heritage and fight with unwavering resolve to better future for all of Californians. Except for those of us, like myself, who are willing and wanting to lead once again with grace and dignity as your elected representative. As I have traveled these past months across our great state, I am humbled, but not surprised by so much support behind our campaign. So much support up and down the state. Californians want what I stand for, what our campaign and the California Republican Assembly stand for, and what President Donald Trump stands for. My campaign is committed to victory in 2018, and we will crush the political corruption. We will continue to work with our president and the people across this country to make America great again, and we will win to make California golden again. Thank you. I am Erin Cruz, and I'm running for United States Senate, and I look forward to your endorsement and support. Thank you.